Okay, so I see some of you are struggling with surface area of triangular prisms, and perhaps the videos that I found for you to watch were not as helpful as me doing it with you guys. So I'm going to reiterate how we find surface area of triangular prisms. So the first thing I want you to do is to stop and think about what the different information you have is. So maybe start by writing this out. So when I'm looking at a triangular prism, the first thing I want to do is I want to identify what are the three sides in my triangle. Okay, so when I look at this triangle on the front, I want to write down all three sides of this triangle. So when I'm looking at it, I have this side length here, which I can see is also 6. I have this side length here, which is 8, and this side length here, which is 10. So I'm going to write down all three sides in my triangle so that I remember what the three different side lengths are. After I do that, I want to find what is the base and the height of the triangle. Okay? Now remember, the base and the height, they must meet at a 90 degree angle. Okay? So I need to find my 90 degree angle. And when I look, I see it's in this corner. Here's the 90 degree angle right there. And the 90 degree angle is touching the 8 centimeter side and the 6 centimeter side. So my base is 8. And my height is 6. The last measurement that you need to know is what we call the height of the prism. And the height of the prism is really the height or the distance from this triangle on the front to the triangle on the back. And so the line that connects my triangle on the front to the triangle on the back is this line right here. So this is the height of my prism, and that distance is 15 centimeters. Okay, so now that we've identified the different information and we've written it out somewhere clear for us to see, I can go and start finding my surface area. So a triangular prism is made up of the triangle. So I'm going to find the area of a triangle first. The way I find area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2. We said on our last page that the base and the height of the triangle are 8 and 6. So my base and my height are going to be 8 and 6. So I have 8 times 6 divided by 2. 8 times 6 is 48, and 48 divided by 2 gives me 24 centimeters squared. Okay, that is the area of one of my triangles. A triangular prism is also made up of three different rectangles. So I'm going to write out R1, R2, R3 to represent my three different rectangles. With these three different rectangles, I am going to use the three sides of my triangle. The triangle has three sides, and off of each side, so this 6 centimeter side here, I have a rectangle. Off of this 8 centimeter side here, I have a rectangle on the bottom of the shape. And off of this 10 centimeter side, I have a rectangle. And that's kind of like the ramp that's going up. So those three sides of the triangle give me the three dimensions for my three different rectangles. So one of them has a 6, one of them has an 8, and the other one has a 10. And those come from the three sides of the triangle. So identify what your three sides of the triangle are, because you're going to need to use them later. All three of those rectangles, so this one, which has that side length of 6, is 6 by 15. Well, what was that 15? That 15 was the height of the prism. The second rectangle that had 8 as its side length also has this 15. So it also has that height of the prism. And rectangle number 3, this one here, also has that side length of 15. So it's 10 by 15. So notice, all three triangle sides are all multiplied by that height of the prism. So all this information that I made sure to make a very specific note of what they were, that's where it all gets used here. Now I need to figure out all of my answers here. 6 times 15 is 90, and 8 times 15 is 120. Oh, I should be writing centimeters squared, sorry, my apologies. And this is 150 centimeters squared, and then we'll write this one here, centimeters squared, as well. Now, the total surface area for a triangular prism. I have my front triangle, and I have my back triangle, so I need to add those two things together. But then I also have rectangle number 1, and rectangle number 2, and rectangle number 3, because a triangular prism is made up of 5 different shapes. We have 5 different faces. The front triangle is 24. I'll write that in blue so we can see where that's coming from. The front triangle is 24. You know what? The back triangle is the same as the front triangle. It's also 24. And if I add 24 and 24, I actually get 48. So see, I already had that number there. So I can cheat a little bit, and I can just know that I need to use that number. But I still want to make sure I'm very clear. Area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2. The only reason it ends up being 48 is because I want 2 triangles that are exactly the same. Okay, so I take this 24 and I do it twice, or multiply it by 2. But then I also have to add in my rectangle number 1, my rectangle number 2, and my rectangle number 3. Adding all 5 of those things together, and I'm trying to do this again quickly off the top of my head, is 408 centimeters squared. Okay, let's do another one, because triangular prisms, they're all kind of different. So this one, again, I'm going to start off. What are the 3 sides to my triangle? I'm going to identify the information before I start trying to do anything with it. The 3 sides to my triangle, here they are, 1, 2, and 3. Well, it looks like in this case, because of these lines, all 3 sides happen to be 8. So I've got 8, 8, and 8. What are now the base and the height of the triangle? And remember, the base and the height of a triangle must meet at a 90 degree angle. The only 90 degree angle I see is here. It's pointing at this yellow dotted line. So this is my height, 6.9. This is my base, which is 8. So, oops, I'm going to switch to green. So my base is 8, and my height is 6.9, because they must meet at a 90 degree angle, and that's the only 90 degree angle I have. The last one is the height of the prism. The height of the prism connects the triangle on the front to the triangle on the back, and that line that does that is this one here, that 12 centimeters. So there's all my 3 numbers. Let's start calculating. So, first thing I do is I find the area of the triangle. Area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2. On the previous page we said 8 was the base and 6.9 was the height. So it's 8 times 6.9 divided by 2. And that equals 55.2 divided by 2, and that's 27.6 centimeters squared. I then have my 3 rectangles, rectangle number 1, rectangle number 2, and rectangle number 3. Okay, now some of you are going to think, well, I got a shortcut. Well, some of you are using the shortcut and doing it wrong. So instead of trying to use a shortcut and doing it wrong, let's just make sure we do it correctly. My 3 sides of the triangle are going to give me my 3 sides of my rectangles, 8, 8, and 8. Well, in this case, they're all the same. So I've got an 8 here. I've got an 8 here, and I've got an 8 here. All 3 rectangles will then have the same height of the prism that they use. So this front one is 8 by 12. And then this one on the bottom is going to be 8 by 12, going all the way to the back, across the bottom. And then this one on the back side of the shape is going to be 8 by 12. 8 by 12, and it's the shape that's on the back. Okay, so I'm going to multiply those 8s, all by 12. So where did the 8s come from? The 8s are the side lengths of my triangle. Where did the 12 come from? The 12 is the height of the prism that connects that front triangle to the back triangle. This one, when we work it out, they all end up being 96 centimeters squared. Could I have taken a shortcut? Sure. But a lot of the time, the shortcut is making us get it wrong. So stop trying to shortcut and doing it wrong. Let's just do it correctly, because it's not that much extra work to just write out all three rectangles. Front side is 27.6. Back side, 27.6. And then rectangle 1, rectangle 2, and rectangle 3. We got 96, 96, and 96. Adding the three 96s is 288, and then we have to add 55.2. And just give me a second here, because I gotta type that in. I can't do that one off the top of my head, or I could, but I don't feel like saying the wrong answer out loud, because then I'll sound foolish. 343.2 centimeters squared. As you get better at this, you might not need to do this step where you write everything out, but for now, do it, because it's going to help you get everything organized. So write down the things you know. What are the three sides of the triangle? 4 is one of them, and then 12 is this one, and then coming down this side, I can see it's equal to 12 because it has that line on there. So my three sides are 4 and 12 and 12. Okay? Base and the height of a triangle need to meet at that 90 degree angle. Here's the 90 degree angle. It is pointing at the 4 side, and it is pointing at the 11.8 side. So my base and my height is 4 and 11.8. The height of the prism, which is referring to how big is the distance that takes us from that front triangle to the back triangle. So here's the front triangle. This line connects me to the back triangle, right? And that distance is 3. So that's what we are using for those different dimensions. So here it is. I've filled this one all in, right? Area, base times height divided by 2. We said the base and the height was 4 and 11.8. So we filled those in. Rectangle number 1, 2, and 3. The three sides of the triangle were 4, 12, and 12. So the three sides go in, one for each rectangle. All three of those rectangles are being multiplied by that 3, that height of the prism. So that's how we are using that different information. Remember the total. We got a front triangle and a back triangle. They should be the same, this measurement that we found there. And then rectangle 1, 2, 3, adding them all together. So in your notes that you're going to have posted on D2L, you already have this information in there. We are finding triangle area, base times height divided by 2, right? And then I've also said here, times 2, because we need to have two of the same triangle. Remember, base and height meet at that 90 degree angle. Rectangle 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3 sides to the triangle, so side 1 goes here in rectangle 1. Side 2 goes here in rectangle 2. Side 3 goes here in rectangle 3. All three things are multiplied by that height of the prism. And remember, the height of the prism takes me from the front of the triangle to the back of the triangle. Or if it was standing up tall where the triangle was laying on the ground and we had a triangle on the top, then it really would be the height going from the bottom to the top. I have also written this out on your notes in words and a description as to what you should be doing. So hopefully this makes it a little bit easier, because now you can refer to the notes as well as the video for finding surface area of triangular prisms.